So what is a SOQL code is, why we are going to use the SOQL. SOQL stands for Salesforce Object Query Language. SOQL stands for Salesforce Object Query Language. This is, SOQLs are used to retrieve the data from database. From the database, if you want to fetch the data, we use SOQL queries. SOQLs are similar to SQL. In the regular databases like Oracle, SQL Server, you write SQL query to retrieve the data. Here, we are going to use SOQL queries to retrieve the data. SOQL queries are used to retrieve the data from the S objects or from the corresponding S object field records or parent records. Using SOQL query, I can fetch all the related records of the S object or its parent object or its child object. When you write a SOQL query, we can get up to 50,000 records. SOQL query can give you maximum 50,000 records. When you write a SOQL query, it can give you maximum of 50,000 records. When you write a SOQL query, the result is going to be in the form of list. Why it is in the form of list? When I say, fetch the records from opportunity, I am not sure how many opportunities are there in the opportunity object. There may be 0 records, there may be 10 records, there may be 1 billion records. I am not sure about number of records are there in the opportunity. When you are not sure about the size, I have to go with what? List. When you are not sure about the number of records, I will go with what? List. If you know the size, we can go with array. If you are not sure about the number of records, what we are going to get, then I am going for list, as it can support all the sizes. So, what was the SOQL of? SOQL of, okay, is nothing but Salesforce Object Query Language. These are similar to what? SQL queries. SOQLs are used to fetch the data from S objects. That may be a standard object or custom object. Using SOQL queries, we can also fetch the data of its corresponding related objects. It may be a child records or it may be your master record or parent record. SOQLs will return you the result in the form of what? List of S object or map of ID, S object. Based on the context, I will use list or map. SOQL query can return you maximum of 50,000 records in a single call. This is the basic information about SOQL. When you want to write a SOQL query, the query is going to be select fields from S object where condition, group by, column name, having, order by, for update, limit, offset. Like this we have a syntax. This is the complete syntax. Select fields from object name where condition, group by, column name, having, order by, for update, limit, offset, all these are options. All these are what? Option. You may use, may not use. But this is a mandatory. Select field names from object name. This is a mandatory. Rest of the things, as per your business requirement, you may append those conditions. Right. Now, when you want to go for a SOQL, Salesforce Object Query Language. Query means what? Query is a statement which is used to retrieve the data from S object. Query can be any one of the statement which is written to fetch the record from the database. So, how do you write the query? If you want to write the query, it has to be like this. I'm giving it. Query. How do you write a query? Write a query to fetch. Write a query to fetch account records. So how to get it, boss? Select. What are the fields in the account? Name. Industry. Own. From. Select field names from S object. Then I'm giving. Write a query fetch user details. When you say write a query to fetch the user details, select last name, first name, profile ID, user role ID from, write a query to fetch profile. Then I'm going to give select name ID from. Similarly, write a query to fetch opportunity data, opportunity record. Select name, stage name, close date from. This is how we are writing a query. Select field names from SOQL. It will clear. Select field names from SOQL. This is how we are writing the query. That's what I give some sample use cases for you. On your hard copy, I give you some sample cases. Write a query to fetch from account object. Select ID, comma, name, industry from account. Then, from where are you going to execute the query? How you are going to execute the query? How the query is going to be executed? From where we are going to execute the query? So when you are trying to execute the query, we are going to use it in this format. SOQL query can be executed in four different formats. Understand the requirement. SOQL query can be executed in four different formats. Look at the first format. When you are writing a SOQL query, it can be executed in four different formats. What is it? List of account. ACCS equal to, I told, result is going to be in the form of list of SOQL. Select name, phone, from, this is one of the way, this is one of the way, where query is fixed. I am very much sure, I am going to write a query on account object, I am going to retrieve name and phone number. Suppose, we have something like this. I have something like this. Look at the point. Object. Then I have something like this. So here you are supposed to choose any one of the objects. Suppose I have choose an account object. I don't know. You may choose account, I may choose contact, somebody may choose opportunity. Are you sure which object you are going to choose? I got a list of objects. From the list of objects, you may choose any one of the objects. If I choose account object, you are getting account fields. From the account fields, you selected some fields like type. Now, are you sure that every time you are going to select the type and rating? No. You may select name. Somebody may select name, phone, industry. I may select name, type. Someone else can select name, industry, rating. So, depends upon whatever the fields you have selected. Now, I have to give a query. So, what is my query now? Select type rating from account. Suppose you have selected name, phone. Select name, phone from account. Suppose you have selected name, phone, industry. Then I have to give select name, phone, industry from account. So is the query is a fixed query? Do you know which fields you are going to select? I am not sure. Do you know which option you are going to select? I am not sure. So what is this query called? Dynamic query. What is this query called? Dynamic query. When the query is not fixed, the query has to be formed. The query has to be formed based on runtime requirement. It is what? Dynamic query. So if you want to go for dynamic SOQL queries, then we are going to make string query equal to select. The second way of executing the query is list of account ACCS equal to database dot query. How we are including database dot query string. The string is formed. The string is formed based on runtime operation. So database dot query. This is what dynamic queries. No, we can also execute like this. Database dot query locator. Query equal to database dot get query locator. This is the third format. We can execute the query list of account ACCS equal to select fields from account, or we can say database dot query query, or else we can say database dot get query locator. We'll see one by one. What I'm saying, these are the formats in which we can write a query. When do we use them? We'll see. When do we use them? We'll see. But in how many ways we can write? We can write it with the select the fields from S object, database.query, database.get query locator. If you want, we can also write like map of ID, account, ACC map equal to new map of ID. So I can write any one of the formats. So query can be executed in how many formats? Four formats. We can execute the query in four different ways. We can execute the query in four different ways. Let us see what are the four ways. When we open the hot copy, now what I have given? What are the four ways we have given? SOQL queries can be executed in four formats. List of S object result equal to query string. List of S object result equal to database.query. Database.query locator result equal to database.getQuery locator. Map of ID S object result equal to new map of ID S object. So query can be executed in four different formats. Query can be executed in four different formats. People are clear? People are clear with this? Right. Now let us see the next one. Let us see the next one. We are trying to write. So look at the format. How we are going to write the query? If you want to write the query is going to be list of account ACCS equal to select name own from, or else we can give list of contact CONS equal to select first name, last name from. Like this we wrote the query. People are clear? Now, from where we can execute the query? You are writing a query, very good. But a query can be executed from where? Suppose you want to retrieve the data and see. You don't want to display somewhere. You want to retrieve the data based on a condition. You want to see how many records are there. What was this boss? Developer console. Open the developer console. Open the developer console. Name. Developer console. Now at the bottom we have a extension. Developer console extension is there. Go to the extension. What you are finding here? Query the writer query. Select name, phone, write a query. Then what we have? At the bottom we have a button called execute. At the bottom we have a button called execute. At the bottom we have a button called execute. You are finding it? Execute. When you click on this execute button, the query will execute. And we are going to get a list of records. So from where I can execute? I can execute the query from query editor, which is available on developer console. On the developer console, we can write a query, click on execute, we can see list of records which are written by the software. List of records which are written by the software. This is one of the way. What is the second way? The second way is go to the open anonymous window. Open anonymous window, write your query, click on execute. The second format is executing the query from anonymous. We can also call the query from where? Apex class. I can create an Apex class. In the Apex class, I can write a query. We can write a query. Now what was this? SOQL query. I can execute the query from query editor, anonymous window, Apex class. If you want, you can also execute the query from trigger. So queries will be written on Apex classes, queries will be written in the Apex classes, queries will be written in the anonymous window, queries will be written in the triggers. In the trigger also we can write a query, or we can call the trigger queries from the JavaScript. From the scripting we can write a SQL queries. From Apex class we can write a SQL queries. From triggers we can execute a SQL queries. From query editor we can execute the SQL query. From the anonymous window we can execute the SQL query. Right. There are some third party tools also. What are the third party tools like? Workbench. Workbench dot developer console. Workbench. From here also I can write the query. So query can be executed even from this. So this is what I told. What are the different locations from where I can execute the SQL queries? What is it? SQL query, account, this is how we are executing the SQL query. Right boss, people have followed this. So what are the different locations from where we can write the SQL query? Right, from where I can execute the SQL query? So we can execute the SQL query from debug anonymous block, query editor, workbench, Apex classes and triggers, and we can also use from toolkit from Ajax. When you say Ajax, JavaScript. From JavaScript to object query we can execute. From the scripting of SalesForce we can execute. So these are the locations from where I can write the SQL query. People are clear with this. So how do you execute from the anonymous window? Username, developer console, panel, debug, open anonymous window. How do you execute from the query editor? Username, developer console, expand the console, you find query editor. How do you read from the workbench? If you want to execute from the workbench, workbench.developer.course.com, select the environment, choose the version, then they say SQL query or what you want to want, what you want to use. Then I can use the SQL query from where? Apex class, triggers and all this format. Then I told you, SQL queries are going to be of two formats. What are the two formats? Static query, dynamic query. Static query means, you know which fields you are going to query. You know from which object you are going to query. You know what are the very conditions you are going to apply. It is a static. Now dynamic means what? Dynamic means what? I am not sure about which fields I am going to query. I am not sure about from which object I am going to query. I am not sure which conditions I am going to write. Then it becomes what? Dynamic. Static SQL query and dynamic SQL query. I told you one example in the page. Choose the object, choose the fields. Then based on the object, the fields will come. Based on the fields what you selected, we have to execute the query. Are you getting my point? Any further queries from here end? People have followed? So these are the basics. Let us execute the basic examples. So look at the first example, the quick overview you have seen. I am going for a first example. What is the first example we have? I am going to write a query. My requirement is write a SQL to fetch all the account records and display in the VFP. What is my requirement? Write a SOQL query to fetch all the account records and display in the VM page. How you are going to write a SOQL query? When you are writing a SOQL query on account, result is going to be what? List of. So why I am giving set and get? As you are trying to display the value in the VM. Right now, what is the value of ACCS? Null. Then public SOQL example. ACCS equal to select name, industry, phone, type, select industry, phone, type from report. I wrote a SOQL query. Now I want to display the data in the VM page. When you want to display the data in the VM page, you want to display the data in the VM page. If you want to display a list of record, what is the concept we use? If I want to display a list of record, what is the concept we use? Page block table, data table, data list, or repeat. Previous example, list I created a list, I only kept my own data, then I displayed. Right now we are getting the data from where? Database. Writing a query, getting the data from database, whatever the data we are getting, that data we are trying to display. Then I am going with this. Control equal to SOQL example. So how will you display? Apex page block. Page block table value equal to what are the list of record? Var equal to E. Where A stands for one of the account record. I am giving column value equal to A dot. A is one record. That record name A dot industry. We have taken this format. So what is the format? Name, industry, phone, rating. This is how we have taken. Go for a preview. So what was this? We have not retrieved the rating. Without retrieving the rating, I am using. So what are the fields? Name, industry, phone, type. So rating, I will display. So go back, have a preview. Here I am giving mode equal to, so that I don't want the background color, I am taking mode equal to main. Go back, see the data, what we are getting, list of account records, whatever we retrieved, that is displayed in the, right, we are writing a SOQL query, retrieving the data, displaying. Are you clear about this? I wrote a SOQL query, I retrieved the data and I was trying to display the data. People are clear? Now the same example, I have a different requirement. The first example is clear. Now we understood what is the purpose of this list. What is the purpose of list? When you are writing a query, we are getting a list of records. That is one of the requirement. My second requirement is, look at the point. I am writing a SOQL query, I am getting the data. Whatever the data I am getting through SOQL query, I want to display the data in this format. Whatever the data I am getting, I want to display the data in this format. So what is the format? We are getting the data. Whatever the data we are getting, the data I want to display in the form of this. So when I want to display in the form of this, we are going to get it. you got the data. So how we are trying to display the data? I want to retrieve the data, I want to display. I'm going to display multiple records. But the problem here is, if you write a SOQL query, you'll get a records. But I'm not only displaying the records, along with the records, I want to display a checkbox. Previous example, when I wrote a SOQL query, I got a list of records. Whatever the list of records you got, I'm displaying. But are you trying to display a list of records? You are trying to display a list of records where every record has a checkbox again. Along with the record, what you want to display? You want to display checkbox. Only if it is a list of record, write a SOQL query, you get a list of record display. But I don't want to display a list of record, I want to display a list of record along with the corresponding checkboxes. Then every row has what? Every row has what? This is account record. This is one record. This is one account record. Along with the account record, what I need? I want one checkbox. So is it a one element or a combination of more than one element? This is what was? Checkbox. So every row has how many elements? Every row has? In the row, how many elements are there, boss? One checkbox, one account record. Row in elements are there. How many elements are there? One checkbox, one account record. It's a combination of two elements. One checkbox, one account. If you want to take a combination of elements, I have to go for what? The upper class. Because every row has two elements. So it's a combination of two elements. List of elements where every element has two sub-elements. Then what is the concept I have to use? Wrapper class. If it is only account record, list of account. It is not only account record. It is what? List of records where it has account record with checkbox. Then what I am doing? I am creating a wrapper class. Let us understand this. I am going for a wrapper class. Account wrapper. Now understand why you are going for account wrappers. In the account wrapper, what we have? I'll make it simple. Account. Account graph. In the account graph, what we have? Public account. Public boolean we wrote a sample query. Because of the sample query we got the data. Now what I want to do, take one by one record, for every record add one checkbox. For every record we need to create one wrapper element and then display in the list. Now what is this? One account record should have one wrapper record. One account record should have one wrapper record. In the wrapper record, what is there? Account record plus checkbox. Every account record should have corresponding wrapper element. In the wrapper element, we need to have a checkbox with the record. In the wrapper element, we need to have a checkbox with the element. So how we are doing was? Let us see this example. SOQL example. I'm going with public. How did you write a SOQL query? Account graph. I am going with public SOQL example. Now we are doing. How do you write a SOQL query? List of account ACCS equal to select name, own, industry, rating, name, phone, industry, rating, then what is the other one went to? Type, from, we got the list of account records. Select name, phone, industry, rating, type from account. Now what I want to do? accounts equal to new list of account. You got the concept of SOQL because I want to retrieve. You got the concept of wrapper because you want to take a combination of elements. You don't want to directly display the data. You want to make a combination of elements and display. There is a reason I am going for a wrapper. The purpose also you should understand. Then, once you got the data, what should I do? Take one by one account record. Account A. Then, for every account record, we have to create corresponding wrapper element. So, how do you create account wrap AW equal to? In the account wrap, what are the elements we have? AW dot ACC equal to A. AW dot ACC, AW dot account record equal to A. Whatever the account record we have in A, same is the same to ACC. Then we have AW dot flag equal to. Then I am giving accounts dot add. So what I have done? I wrote a SQL query. Then take one by one record. Record from the ACCs and create corresponding wrapper element. Create a corresponding wrapper element and add them to take one by one record from the ACCs and create the corresponding wrapper element, add them to echoes. Now you want to display this data in the VF page. The same data you want to display. Now are you displaying list of account records? No. What are you displaying? List of account wrapper. Previous example, what did you display? List of accounts. But what are you displaying now? List of account wrapper. Okay. Why you have gone for account wrapper? Because they want one record with the corresponding flag value. Right. Now how do you display? Visual Force, SQL example. Controller. Then I am giving effects. First of all, I don't want the sidebars. Sidebar equal to. Then I want to take effects, age block. Then I want to display mode equal to 22. Mode equal to main detail. Then page block. Value equal to accounts. When you say accounts, it's a list of. When you say accounts, it's a list of what? Account wrappers. In the account wrapper, what is the first value you want to print? Checkbox. Column equal to apex input value equal to a dot checkbox you created. But the checkbox should also be created again. When you create apex column input checkbox, checkbox is coming in the body. But I want the checkbox to be printed in the header also. In the header I want to print checkbox. If you want to print anything other than a text value, if you want to print any value other than text as a header, what is the concept we used to use? Apex name equal to giving apex. Apex special name equal to input checkbox. Then how did you get the value? We got it. The header also we got. Then what are the other things that we have? Apex column value equal to dot a dot acc dot. In a code wrapper there is acc. In that AGC we have x colon value equal to a dot ACC dot. Then we have title. Are we equal to a dot, this is dot. So we have account a dot agc dot name, a dot agc dot industry. This is how we got the data. Now you need to decide the format in which straight away you want to display the data, list of accounts. You don't want to display the data straight away, you want to apply some extra concepts, then we need to go for the wrapper class. So basically, SOQL is used for what? Retrieving the data from the database. All the previous example, I created a list, I only inserted the data in the list and I displayed. But now we are not inserting the data manually, we are retrieving the data which is there in the database. People have followed this concept. Everyone is clear with this? People are clear with this concept? Basic SOQL query. Now SOQL will give you what? List of S object. Why are you going for a list? Why are you going for a list? When I wrote a SOQL query, I am not sure how many records you are going to get. SOQL query is going to give you how many records, we are not sure. It may give you 10, 20 or 100, we are not sure about it. That's the reason we are going with it. List of S object. People are clear? Right. Now, next example I want to take. I want to write a SOQL query, retrieve the data. I can retrieve only 5 records. How many records you want to retrieve? Only 5 records. When I wrote a SOQL query, 1000 records came. I don't want 1000 records boss, I want only 5 records. So I am saying, boss, when you write a query, it is giving the result. From the result, how many records you want? You wrote a SOQL query, you got the result. From the result, how many records you want? It is given by limit. Limit will say, how many records should be written from the result. Understand my statement. How many records should be written from the result? That means, query is executed, it got all the 1000 records. From 1000 records, how many you want? It is not saying give me 5 records. It is saying what? Run the query, get the result. From the result, how many records you want? So when you write a SOQL query, it is going to give you a result. From the result, how many records you want, you have to display. Are you getting my point? Here, what is the statement we are using? We are using a statement called limit. 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 Number of records. I can give. Limit 1. When you say limit 1, only 1 record will be given. Limit 10, give me 10 records. Limit 20, give me 20 records. Limit 5, limit 20, limit 30. It indicates how many records should be written from the result. Now, if I give limit equal to 1, limit as 1, how many records we are going to get? Only 1 record, right? If it is only 1 record, can I give it like this? Account AGC equal to select ID comma name from account. Limit 1 means I am sure I am going to get 1 record only. When you say limit 1, you are sure that you are going to get 1 record. When it is only 1 record, when you are sure, should I go for list? Are you getting my point? When you say limit 1, how many records maximum will give you? 1 record. So what I can take? Account ACC. When you feel that you are going to get more than 1 record, or when you are not sure, then we take list. Here in this case, I am very much sure I am going to get only 1 record. Then what I will do? Account ACC equal to. People are clear? When you are sure that the result will be only 1 record, straight away I can give account ACC. I don't need a list. Now I told limit 5. Where is the limit 5? It has to be what? AGCS is equal to? Now we are getting a group of records. We are going for what? List. We are going for a group of records. We are going for a list. Are you clear about this context? Limit will specify how many records should be written from the result. How many records should be written from the result. Now, I have a use case like this. I have a use case like this. What is my use case? I have a VF page. Here I have a request. Number of records. We have a request. Here we have some value. Some options are there. 1. The options are 1, 5, 10, 25, 50. Like these options are there. Like these options are there. You may choose any one of the options. Yeah. See, array or list both are one of the same boss. Only thing is, array is also a list. List is also an array. Only thing is, array will not grow, list will grow. But referring to the array or the list, both are one and the same. One and the same. Internal concept is the same. Okay. Doesn't make much difference there. Now I gave list of records. Initially what happened? Initially, when I open, initially 5 records should be opened. Initially how many records you want to open? Only 5 records. Or let us say 3 records I want to display. Name, phone, first time when I load the page, automatically 3 records should be opened. Initially, how many records should be displayed? 3 records. When I will select, if I select 5 and click on submit, 5 records should be displayed. If I select 20 and submit, 20 records. But first time when I am loading, how many records should be displayed? 3 records. By default, 3 records will be displayed. If you want, go to the pick list, select how many records you want, submit, those many records will come. Did you get my point here? Did you get my point here? Initially, how many records? 3 records. So let me give you this concept. The same example I am going to give you. Right. So you want to display a pick list. Give it the pick list, what I need? Select. Select option. And similarly, what I want to give was public list of now we have a toughest task here, understand public SOQL example. What is the first condition? AGCS is equal to select name, phone, I got the data, then pick list I am creating, new, list of, select, list of option, now, integer. What are the values we have? 1, 5, 10, 15, then I want to take one by one option. I is less than. Rows dot size. Now, picklist will take only what type of values? String only, right? Picklist will take what type of value? Label should be string, value should be string. Picklist, label is string, value is string. Then, label is string, value is string. Then how should I create? Select the option, OB equal to new select option, item label, comma, item value. Item label comma item value. Now the question mark is how to convert integer to string in FX. You need to understand the functions in FX. How to convert integer to FX in the there is a predefined functionality that we open the class. Typecast we need, we take a predefined functions we can take. What are the predefined function? Okay. So look at the format. So we have some value we got which you want to convert. String dot value of. So there's a predefined class called string. So what do you want to refer? String class in. Look at the string class. There is a predefined class called string. Now understand the methods what you have there. So here we have value of, I think last method will be there. Value of, if I give value of integer, or value of this one. If I give integer value, it is going to convert into string. Now, why I am saying use the function? You might have simply given like this, right? If you want to convert, simply I can give it like this. Plus. If I give plus I, string plus anything is a string only. By default, you will get a string. Why I am insisting on a function? Now, if I give like this, sum plus age. What is the output you are getting? Sharp 30. String plus anything will give you what? String. If I give single quotes, it's a string. String plus I, if I give, you are going to get the value as what? Then there is a string. But why I am insisting on the function? Because later on when you want to reuse, string should be converted into integer again. It's not only displaying the value to string. Now, when you select the picklist, what is the value I am going to get? String. The string has to be converted back into integer. And also you need to understand, there are some predefined methods available in the string to read 4th character, to read 10th character, to convert into lowercase, to get the last 4 characters. There are some predefined methods which are available, which you need to understand. We are going to use these methods in long run. What I am going to use? Similarly, we have a predefined class called integer. So what is the integer? Now this integer class is required. Why? Because if I give a string, it should convert into what? If I give a string, again it should be converted back into integer. So what are the methods we have? Let us open. Value of string to long. If I give value, it will convert the value into what? It is converting the value into what? Long. Are you getting my point again? So we have value of. If we give a string, it will convert into. Are you getting my point? So, I have introduced this concept a bit alien, but it's okay. Now what I'm going to give? String dot value of string dot value of what? Rows of I am not displaying them like an integer, I am displaying them like a string. Converting the integer into string and adding them with the option. Then we have variable does not exist. Where is that string? Is it a static method? Value of. Okay. Now, come back to the next one. You have done with this. What is the first query I told? I hope you got this point. So, what is the functionality I have done? Select option will only take string parameters. So, to convert integer into string, we are using predefined methods of the string. What is the method? String dot value of this will convert integer to string. Now I told, whenever you open the page, I told three records will be displayed. So how the three records will be displayed? ACC is equal to select. I already wrote it for you. ACC is equal to select name, phone, industry, type from account. Only three records I told. So I should give as what? Limit. So first time when you load, page will load with only three records with a given quick list option. So let us see here. If people are not followed, let me know, I can re-explain. Apex. Then I am giving here. Apex. Log. Page log. Then I am giving appends select list size equal to 1. Select options value. So anything that I write in the page log buttons that will be printed on the header. Then I am giving fix. Then what I want to display? I want to display list of record. How do you display list of record? The same story, page block table value equal to then I am taking fx column value equal to a dot name column value equal to a dot industry column value equal to a dot form. Like this idea. So what was this page block? What is location? Have a preview. Can you go for a preview? We got it. Account, we have a list of options, 5, 10, whatever I am giving, I am going to select. So initially should we give none value? If I give none value, it is bold put. So what should I add? I selected none value. So go back and see the page now. This is what you do. Initially how many records are displayed? 3 records. Now what happened? If I change submit, if I change and submit, now what is this? Give me 5 records. Now previously I gave limiting code to you directly. But now the limiting is not directly given. Limiting is coming from the program. So what is it? Limiting is coming from the program. How do you assign the dynamic value in the limit? If you are taking a static value, if it is a static value, I give limit 5, limit 10, I can give straight away. But now it is not a static value, it is a dynamic value. Now, if it is a dynamic value, I am giving a size. Limit, colon, size. Limit, colon, size. If you are trying to use a variable name in the SOQL query, if you are trying to use a variable name in the SOQL query, it should be colon followed by variable name. Now, it should be what? Colon followed by variable name. If you want to use the variable name in the SOQL query, if you want to use the variables in the SOQL query, it should be colon followed by variable. Now, how should I give? Limit colon size. Limit colon. So, limit is colon, the variable. Are you getting my point? Now, look at this point. Here I am giving. Public void. Very recent. Based on the number of Based on the value what you selected, if you select 10, 10, 20, 20. Now if you select, what type of value you are going to get? Select option is going to have what? Label as a string, value as a string. So when I select, we are not getting 5. We are getting what? String to 5. So what should I do? Convert the string 5 into size equal to value of so what I'm doing, I'm converting the string to 5. You know, when you select the pick list, what value you're getting? You're getting 5 like this. It is not 5, it is a character 5, string 5. When I select, I'm not getting 10, I'm getting 0, okay. I'm getting what? 10. It is not 10, it is what? 10. 10 plus 10 will give you 1010. 10 plus 10 will give you 1010. 10 plus 10 will give you 20. Now what the point? If I give 10 plus 10, output is 1010. It is not an integer, it is a string. If I want to use, what should I do? Convert string into integer. Convert the string into integer and use it. Now how are you going to use? Look at the format. Same query. Then I'm going to use same query. No difference in the query. The same query. But now I'm not going to use limit 3. I'm going to use variable size. How are we going to use? Limit colon size. Why colon? Because size is a variable. I am not giving 5 constant, I am giving what? Variable, I am giving a variable called size. So limit colon size. Limit colon size. People are clear? What did I do? When I am creating the pick list, converted the integer into string, created a pick list. In the pick list, when I select the value, I am getting a string. Again, I convert the string into Again, you convert the string into integer and use it. Go back here. Then, action equal to result. Refresh, I will preview. Select the file. You got 5 records. 10. Dynamically, we are popping. So, how many records you want? They are going to display the option. Select how many records you want. Accordingly, they are going to get a number of records. Are you clear about this? So, the point here is, pick list will take only what? String, comma, string. But what do you want to display? Numerical values. So you are converting that numerical to string. How do you convert? String dot to value of integer. Then when you select the value, quick list will give you what? String. But what do you want? You want the equivalent integer value. You want equivalent decimal value. Then what I am doing? Converting string into integer. How? Integer dot value of. People are clear? Then when you are writing a SQL query, limit. Limit is to tell you what? How many records you want? How many records should be written from the SQL query? How many records should be written from the SQL query? If it is a constant value, straight away we can give what? Limit 5, limit 10. But if you are trying to use, a variable, limit colon variable name. Limit colon variable name. I hope you are clear. I hope you got the use cases. People are clear? Right. So where did we use this concept? Look at this. At the bottom, what they are giving? Record, read 10 records. Read 25 records. Are you getting? How did it achieve? The same. Now how did they achieve? SQL query, based on the option what you selected here, SQL query on lead object, convert the SQL result into the wrapper class, because they display what? Records along with checkboxes. So they converted the list of lead into list of lead wrapper, and they are displayed. While writing the SQL query, they told per page how many records? 25 records. Are you getting my point? I hope you are clear with this concept. One of the examples. Right? So, any further queries from this today's session? People have followed? I will also complete one small topic before I wind, which is called offset. Offset means, when you write a SQL query, we got 1000 records. From 1000 records, how many you want? 5. Limit 5. From 1000 records, I want 20. Limit 20. When I say offset, when I wrote a SQL query, I got 1000 records. Okay, when you got 1000 records, from 50th record, display the remaining records. From 100th record, display the remaining records. From the result, when you got a result, from which record you want to take the result? You wrote a SQL query, you got 50 records. Okay, you got 50 records. From 5th record, display the result. From 20th record, display the result. Offset will say from which record. Offset will say from which record. Limit will say how many records. Offset will say starting from which record. Offset will say starting from which record. Are you getting my point? Let me give you quick understanding. So query. Query editor. When you wrote the query, let us see how many records we got. How many records came? 13 records. I told offset. Offset 10. When I say offset 10, from 10th record, give me the remaining records. So how many records? So offset is counted from what? 0. Then offset is counted from 0. So when I told offset 10, from 10th record it is giving the remaining records. I told offset 5. From 5th record, index 5 is giving. So what was that? 8 records. Offset will say from which record? Offset will say from which record? So what is the value we are going to take? Offset, not in the table, in the result offset. So query will execute, we get a result. In the result from which record? It is not from which record in the table, it is from which record in the result. Write a SQL query, get the result, which record in the result. From which record in the result you want. So offset, we give offset 5, offset 10, like that we give. What is the maximum value of offset? Maximum value of offset is 2000. What is the maximum value of offset? 2000. We can give maximum value of offset as 2000. We cannot go more than 2000. Offset value, maximum value of offset is 2000. Maximum value of offset is 2000. Maximum value of offset is 2000. I hope I am clear. People have followed. Right. Go to the hard copy. So what did I give in the notes for you? So, first example I have taken. SQL query to retrieve the example. You can take the classroom examples. But I gave some sample examples in the hard copy also. Limit. What is the purpose of limit? How the limit can be used? What is the purpose of offset? How the offset can be used? I give different combinations. Okay. Suppose if you want to use a limited offset together, I want to say from 5th record give me 20 records. From third record give me 5 records. From 3rd record means offset 3. From 3rd record give me how many records? 5 records. 5 records means limit. If you want to take the combination, you can take the combination. From 10th record give me 50 records. From finite record give you 5 records, limit offset. But if you are trying to take limited offset together, you are writing limit followed by offset. The combination is what? Limit followed by offset. When you want to take them together, it should be what? Always limit followed by offset. From 5th record give me 100 records. So from 5th record means offset, 100 record means limit, limit 100, offset 5. From 1000 record give me 2000 records. From 1000 record give me 2000 record. So limit 2000, offset 1000, offset 1000. Always limit followed by offset. Right, boss? You can access the hard critical notes over here. Every point is mentioned.